A dentist, after practicing dentistry for 10 years, has become a waste warrior. Everyone is curious on why is this so, that two unrelated things. One incident in my life has made me feel my requirement in this space of waste management is much more. Myself, along with my friends, have achieved 90% segregation in our neighborhood, which is HSR layout, and we could enforce plastic ban successfully. That's when I joined a team of solid waste management roundtable, which is working at Bengaluru city level. So a lot of passionate solid waste management practitioners together are thriving to get this Bengaluru model. What is this Bengaluru model? Bengaluru model of solid waste management compulsorily talks about three-way segregation at source, pushing as many people as possible for composting, managing their own wet waste, and plastic ban enforcement and sustainable menstruation. We have dry waste collection centers in many wards of Bengaluru. If you have an effect that nobody can replicate, your phenomena fades away. So if you want to have a legacy, then you better put effort to develop something which is replicable. The Bengaluru model of solid waste management is such that it can be easily replicated by any municipality or panchayat in just 3 to 6 months. If you have a strong will to bring about a change in your neighborhood, a dynamic leadership either among citizens, elected representatives or municipality to ensure that it is achieved and sustained. The Bengaluru model strongly believes in segregation of waste at source into three categories. This has been the mantra for successful SWM drives across the city. Now, this effort of Bengaluru model, I would like to take you through how Siddipet, a town in Telangana, implemented the model. Under the Swachh Bharat mission trainings, a lot of municipalities visit Bengaluru for workshops and field visits to learn our best practices. During one such visit, the elected representatives of Telangana visited Swachhagraha Kalika Kendra, which is the only composting learning center in India. Here, you get to see many models churning out compost day in and day out. The visitors were highly impressed by what they saw in Kalika Kendra and wanted to replicate this in Siddipet. In the following days, I was invited to Telangana to convince their MLA, who was the finance minister of Telangana, to implement this. The session was attended by 2,000 people, including the corporators, MLAs, MPs, panchayat secretaries and MPDOs. Once they were convinced, the MLA designed the roadmap. Just like all other municipalities, Siddipet was also landfilling its mixed waste at Busapur, which is 17 kilometers away from the city. So first thing first, we got three-way segregation mandated without delay. Dry waste was collected only twice a week, whereas wet and reject was collected on the other days. Sufficient number of vehicles were pressed into service to ensure regular pickup. Audio announcements were thoroughly scheduled. Awareness sessions were conducted for schools, self-help groups, government offices, residential layouts, apartments, neighborhood panchayats. Waste pickers, resource persons and health officials were trained, made aware of the importance of three-way segregation. And fines were implemented on those who put out mixed waste and littered public places. The Siddipet MLA insisted that every councillor be on the ground every single day to ensure the garbage pickup is 100% and segregation is done perfectly. So they conducted 15 days. Every 15 days there was a monitoring meeting. The effect, within 3 months, segregation at source was achieved. Wet waste. As of wet waste, the composting was insisted in 4 wards of Siddipet. In 4 wards, ward level composting was taken and now the city has awarded a biogas plant for the city's wet waste. And the dry waste collection center is another prerequisite for successful segregation. Siddipet has constructed one center which receives around 5 metric tons per week. Siddipet municipality, with the support of elected representatives, announced ban on single-use plastics. To make sure that single-use plastics are avoided, 34 wards of Siddipet had steel banks. They developed an app so that you book your steel cutlery for any event in your house. So this is an awesome improvement with regard to ban on single-use plastics. Coming to sustainable menstruation, the municipality of Siddipet has conducted a training for women to learn how to make cloth sanitary napkins and also promoted sustainable menstruation through awareness sessions on menstrual cups. So all in all, Siddipet wanted to become the model to the whole of Telangana state. And another benchmark what Siddipet has achieved is developing a Swachh Badi, which is a replication of Swachhagraha Kalika Kendra. Swachh Badi now has a 360 degree SWM learning center where everything about wet waste, dry waste and the reject waste and how to process and destination for each is explained there. Now we are expecting the whole of Telangana state, all the municipalities and panchayats to visit Swachh Badi and learn more about composting and waste management. So this is how replication of the model will be successful. As I said in the beginning, it takes determination, dynamic leadership, well thought out strategies and systemic implementation to get successful SWM model rolling. If Siddipet can do it, I don't see why it cannot happen anywhere else. So next, it could be your own town or city. If you want to be the change maker, it is possible to achieve within 3 to 6 months. So if every city, municipality and town starts replicating this with a blueprint which is available, very soon we see Swachh Bharat and we can be proud of our nation.